Welcome to a lesson on synthetic division used for polynomial division. The goal of this video is to perform synthetic division to divide by a binomial in the form of x minus k. So notice the divisor will be in the form where the degree is 1 and the leading coefficient is also 1. For an explanation of synthetic division, we'll discuss synthetic division of a third degree polynomial. And so we'll use synthetic division to divide a polynomial in this form by x minus k. So you can see the first step is to list the coefficients here and list the value of k here. It's important to note that k is found by having the binomial in the form of x minus k. So if this was x minus 3, k would be 3. To perform synthetic division, we start by bringing the a value down, then we multiply by k and put it in the next column. Multiply by k on the diagonal, add down, and continue. So the process here, the vertical pattern in red is to add, and the diagonal pattern in blue is to multiply by k. And the bottom row represents the coefficients of the quotient, which is 1 degree less than the dividend. So since this is degree 3 and this is degree 1, our quotient would be degree 2. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Here I have the notes from the previous page. Let's see if we can set this up. The first step is to identify the coefficients of the dividend. So we'd have a 1, negative 3, positive 4, and negative 7. Next, we need to identify the value of k in the form of x minus k. So the value of k in this problem, because we're dividing by x minus 3, would be a positive 3. I always find it easy to just take the opposite sign of what we see here in the divisor. Now the process starts by bringing down the leading coefficient of 1, and then on the diagonal we multiply by k. So 3 times 1 would equal positive 3, and the vertical pattern is to add. So negative 3 plus 3 would be 0. Now this is quite different than long division. Remember, when we did long division, we subtracted each time, but for synthetic division, we add. The diagonal pattern is we multiply by k. 3 times 0, of course, is 0. Vertical pattern is to add. Diagonal pattern is to multiply by k, so 3 times 4 equals 12. And the result here would be positive 5. These are the coefficients and the remainder of our quotient. So since we started with a degree 3 polynomial and divided by a degree 1, our quotient would be 1x squared plus 0x plus 4. This is our remainder, so we'd have plus 5 over the divisor. Remember, the divisor is x minus 3. Now to clean this up, of course, we would not want to leave the zero term in our final answer or the leading coefficient of 1. So we write this as x squared plus 4 plus 5 over x minus 3. So this is a very nice way to divide by a binomial as long as it fits the form required for synthetic division. You can see it's much faster than performing long division. Let's try another. First, we need our coefficients in descending order, so we're going to have a 2, a 6. Now there's no x term, so we have to have a 0 coefficient for x, and then 29. So we have 2, 6, 0, and 29. If we leave off the 0, the process will not work correctly. Next, we need the value of k. It says x plus 4, so I know the value of k will be negative 4. So we start off by bringing the 2 down, and we multiply by k on the diagonal. This would be negative 8. Add would be negative 2. Again, multiply by k. This would be positive 8 now. Add, multiply by k. Negative 4 times 8 equals negative 32. The sum here would be negative 3. This is all we need to find the quotient. So if we take a degree 3 divided by a degree 1, the quotient will be degree 2. So our quotient will be 2x squared minus 2x plus 8 minus the remainder over the divisor, which is x plus 4. Here's our final quotient. Let's go ahead and try another one. First, list the coefficients. Notice we will not have any zero terms here. Since the divisor is x plus 5, k will be minus 5 or negative 5. Start by bringing the leading coefficient down, multiplying by k, that'd be negative 10, adding, multiplying by k, positive 20, adding, multiplying by k, and here we see we have a remainder of 0. So our quotient will be 2x squared minus 4x plus 3. Again, we have degree 3 divided by degree 1, which means our quotient will be degree 2. Since this does divide evenly into this polynomial, we could say that x plus 5 is a factor of this polynomial. Let's take a look at a couple more. Now we're taking a degree 5 and dividing by a degree 1. This quotient will be a degree 4 polynomial. Let's set it up. First, we need our coefficients. Leading coefficient is a 1, y to the 5th. We'd have 0 y to the 4th, 0 y to the 3rd, 0 y to the 2nd, 0 y, and negative 32. So let's check that again. Y to the 5th is given. 0 y to the 4th, 0 y to the 3rd, 0 y squared, 0 y, and our constant. Our value of k, because we see y minus 2, k will be positive 2. Start by bringing the leading coefficient down, multiply by k, adding, multiply by k, add, multiply by k, add, and multiply by k, and add, and lastly, multiply by k, and add. So it looks like we have another remainder of 0, which means y minus 2 is a factor of this degree 5 polynomial. So we have a degree 5 divided by a degree 1, so this would be a degree 4, so 1 y to the 4th, and then decreasing by 1 degree each time, plus 2 y to the 3rd, plus 4 y squared, plus 8 y, plus 16, and again a remainder of 0, so here's our quotient. Okay, let's try one more. Now, if you take a look at this last problem, notice how it's not in the form that we need it to be in. Remember that the divisor has to be in the form of x minus k. So normally we would just perform long division on this problem, but there is a way to kind of work through this. If we divide everything by 2, this would not affect the quotient. So we can divide this by 2, and this by 2, and every other term by 2. And if we do that, we can still work the problem using synthetic division. The next thing to notice on this problem is that these terms are not in descending order. So let's rewrite this in the correct order at the same time. This would be the same as 8x cubed minus 6x squared plus 7x minus 1 divided by x plus 1 half. Okay, so let's go ahead and perform synthetic division in this form and see what we get. So our coefficients, 8, negative 6, 7, negative 1, and the value of k, it says x plus 1 half, so k would be negative 1 half. Okay, now the process will be the same. We'll bring down the 8, multiply by negative 1 half, that would be negative 4, add, multiply by k, that'd be positive 5, add, multiply by negative 1 half, that would equal negative 6, the remainder of negative 7. Now let's interpret these results. Degree 3 divided by degree 1, this is the coefficient of the degree 2 term. So we'd have 8x squared minus 10x plus 12 minus 7 over our divisor, which would be x plus 1 half. Now this is the correct quotient, but it's in kind of an odd form because the original problem had a divisor of 2x plus 1. So what we could do is multiply both the top and the bottom by 2 over 2, which would result in 14 in the numerator and 2x plus 1 in the denominator. This would be the correct quotient for this division problem. Now you might ask yourself whether it's worth doing synthetic division on this problem, or maybe you would just convert back to long division. It really is your preference. Personally, I would probably just do long division, but if you're set on performing synthetic division, you can do it this way. I hope you found this video helpful, and have a great day.